Thank you. Welcome to this channel. This is your host, Pastor Joseph Minor. And today, we are going to understand a bit of what happened and will happen at the end time. This one, we get it more from the book of Revelation. And today, we are going to read from Revelation 16 and from verses 12. There are so many things that have happened before we come to this verse 12, because we are on the sixth angel. So we had some other angels before we come to this one. And so the first ones have talked about what would also happen. But more so today, I want us to remind ourselves of some of the things which we have started seeing around us. And the Bible says, "And the sixth angel poured out his vial upon the great river Euphrates, and the water thereof was dried up, that the way of the kings of the east might be prepared. And I saw three unclean spirit like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon and out of the mouth of the beast and out of the mouth of the false prophet. For they are the spirits of devils working miracles which go forth unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world to gather them to the battle of that great day of God Almighty." I want to remind you, my friends, there are those people who have started now coming up as false prophets, which were found in the book of Revelation 16. They will come and perform miracles, and they will deceive many, and they will attract even the kings. We have them even in our this nation, Kenya. We have them even in the worldwide churches. And I'm telling you, my brothers and my sister, keep watching. Pray that God may give you the revelation. Pray that may God connect you with the right preachers and the right people. Because in this end time, both the good preachers or the true preachers and even the false prophets or false preachers will be there. It's my prayer that you also pray before you take everything for a true miracle to confirm whether it has come from God. Why? And how? Because it is very important for your life, for you may suffer. For the Bible says that the blessings of the Lord are without repentance. Ya kwamba baraka za Bwana hazina majuto. Lakini hiyo ni kusema ya kwamba, na hiyo ni kumaanisha ya kwamba, kuna baraka zingine zinaweza kuwa na majuto. Not everyone who tells you what you ate yesterday. Not everyone who tells you that your neighbor on your left is have bewitched you is a true Christ, is a true prophet, is a true man of God. No! I'm saying this one before you and before them, because I know they are listening to me. I'm saying, in these last days, confusion may come. But thank God, because if you get or you anchor yourself in Christ Jesus, he'll be reminding you, of the things that are of the Lord. And he'll quicken your spirit when you are going astray, and we shall know them by their fruit. So, my dear brother, my sister, these last days,
itakuwa na shida. Nimekutana na wengi. Wameniuliza mchungaji, tutawajua kinamna gani? Tutawatofautishaje? Niwaambia kitu ambao unataka uombe ni uwe na roho wa kupambanua. Sio roho wa kuona mambo. We have a discerning spirit and we have the spirit of roho ya definition. There is the discerning spirit and the definition spirit. Definition inakuonyesha mambo ambayo imefanyika na haina suluhisho. But the spirit of God, when it reveals what is the problem, it gives you the answer too. So this is the time when you should know where you should start. We have them here in Kenya. Asking money. Kuimbia watu pesa. Lipa pesa hizi. Kukifikia sijui wiki ngapi. Utakuwa umetajirika mpaka wapi. Watu musikibizana na pesa. A time has come when you should understand. We should not follow miracles. Miracles should follow you. Because the Bible tells us what? Miracles, signs, and wonders shall follow you believers. Believe in the Lord and you should see those miracles. But when you follow miracles, you may go to the miracles of the Antichrist. You go to the miracles of the false prophet. You go to the miracles produced by the dragon. So my brother and my sisters, I want to tell you this day that we have the men of God who are still there, alive and kicking. And if you want to know and to see them, one of them is the one who is speaking to you this day. So please, take watch, keep watching, because they are coming to deceive us. In the book of Matthew 24, let us read and understand better of what the Bible is trying to direct us. Matthew 24. We are all there. The book of Matthew 24. I'm not going to read the whole chapter. The whole chapter. Allow me to read from verses 19. We are there. The Bible says, "And all unto them that are with child, and to them that give suck in those days." Wale watakuwa na watoto, watakuwa na watoto ambao wananyonya, hawatakuwa na wakati wa kuconcentrate on what God may be doing in the last days, wanaambiwa ole kwao. But pray, eat that your fright be not in the winter, neither on the Sabbath. Kusiwe wakati wa starehe. Kusiwe wakati ambao ni wa baridi. Na wakati wa baridi, ni baridi ya nje na baridi ya kiroho. Unajua wakati ambapo kuna baridi ya nje, hata baridi ya kiroho hupatikana. Watu hawakuji kanisani, kwa sababu kuna baridi, kuna matope, kuna nini. Wanakuwa na vikwazo nyingi. And what is why the Bible is saying, ole kwa wao. So please, work for your own salvation with fear and trembling. Tafuta Bwana madamu apatikanapo. Kwa sababu kuna wakati ambao hawezi patikana. Like now, if you can say, those who only hear from their pastors, I'm telling you, they don't have TVs at home. They don't have the modern mobile phones. They cannot hear me. They cannot hear another preacher. What are they feeding on? And that is why we should work on our own salvation with fear and trembling. And that is why we should feed ourselves more through the word of God. Soma neno la Bwana na roho wa Bwana atakuhuisha. You know the spirit does not feed you with the word. The spirit quicken what you have in yourself. The word that you have read, he quickens. He brings it to life. He He brings us to understanding. So read the word of God. Naambiaga watu, hata kama unajitupa kwa maji, na utaki kuwa na maji, utapata maji tu. Kwa hivyo soma neno, hata kwa sahia kama halina kwa aliko msaada kwako, wakati roho wa Bwana atakuja, atakuta lile neno, na atalihuisha na utaona litakuwa msaada. Kwa hivyo kaa kwa neno, na utapata kufaidika. Kwa hivyo inasema, 21, for then shall be great tribulation such as was not since the beginning of the world. Inasemekana kutakuwa na shida mingi siku za mwisho. The end time. Itakuwa na shida mingi kama hazijawahi kuonekana hapo mbele na hazitaonekana tena. So I think that even this coronavirus is just coming to us like a cat. Wala ambao wamesoma, wamefika university, wana some college, wanasikiaga kitu inaitwa cat. Hiyo ni kitu ambayo inakuja katikati ya muhula, inasema nafanywa tu mitihani kidogo kidogo ambayo itajumulishwa kwa mtihani ule wa mwisho. Ama wale ambao wako primary wanajua kuna kitu ambayo wanakiitaga mock, wanakiita wala hata wale wako secondary. Hizo ni majaribio ambayo inakuja. Na kwa hivyo hata kwetu tunaweza kuona hii hata coronavirus hii na nzige ambazo tulikuwa nazo na hii mito kujaa na kubeba watu. Na nataka niwaambie ni kama majaribio. Kuna kile ambacho kitakuja before the coming of the Lord, they are going to witness some tribulation, shida kubwa. Na mimi sio mimi nimesema. Soma Biblia yako pamoja na mimi. 21 nimetuambia, for then shall be great tribulation such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, nor ever shall be. Hiyo itakuja, haijawahi kuonekana. 22, that is now where the Bible gives us even a chance to pray. Tusikutane na hiyo mazito. Inasemaji, 22, and accept those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. Tuombe Bwana, the elect's sake, wale ambao wamesimama vyema, wale ambao wamechaguliwa na Bwana. Wewe Mungu alikutoa kwa watu wenu ambao walikuwa wameamini miungu ya kigeni, miungu ya baba zao, na akakuleta kwa Mungu muumba wa nchi akakuokoa. Wewe ndiye utasimamisha hata unaweza usimamisha hata wokovu katika nyumba yenu. Kwa hivyo nataka nikuambie, omba hata hizo siku siwe shortened. 23, then if any man shall say unto you, lo, here is Christ, or there, believe it not. For there shall arise, oh, that is now where people are saying, they are coming on the tele, and they are saying, oh, bring the sick, do whatever. It's as if the Lord is after the miracles. Let me tell you, the Bible calls miracles what? The food of, or the milk of the children of God. The milk. Hiyo ni kitu ya kwanza tu, ili umujue ni Mungu. Lakini ukifika kukula chakula kigumu, utakuwa umefika kiwango kama Shamishek na Shadrach na Abednego. Walisemaje? Ukitutupa kwenye huu moto, Mungu atuokoe, basi ni sawa. Ukitutupa, tukufe, ni sawa. Sisi hatuna shida kumujua Mungu kibinafsi. Si kwa sababu ya kuokolewa, si kwa sababu ya kukula, si kwa sababu ya miujiza. Kwa sababu hiyo inaweza kukupoteza, dada yangu. Ukilala tu siku unauliza ni nani mwingine ataenda kuniombea. Nimeombewa na watatu. Amini. Si vibaya kuombewa, lakini ombewa na yule mtu ambaye atakufunza neno ambalo utaweza kujisimamisha wakati wa shida, wakati wa dhiki. Wewe mwenyewe utajiokoa. And that is why the Bible is very specific, and is saying, Linda moyo wako. Work on your own salvation in fear and trembling. Wewe mwenyewe. Tafuta neno. Lakini ukisikia kila wakati, oh, ni kuna miujiza pande hii, kuna ingine pande hii, uwe wakusunguka Kenya mzima na dunia mzima. Hei, anga nitaenda Nigeria, kuna mtu anatenda miujiza pale. Let me tell you, don't be deceived. That is not me. It's what the Bible has said. That kukiwa na mtu, hapo juu kidogo metuambia, Eve 23, that if any man shall say unto you, lo, here is Christ, or there, believe it not. Why? Because watu wengi watatokea na kuwajaribu watu wa Mungu kuwapoteza, kuwapeleka jia ile ambayo haifai. Wakifikiria miujiza ndio tu inatakikana. Let me tell you something I have been saying. And this one, it's not me, but the Bible says it so. It says that, the Bible says this, if it is the eye which will make you go to hell, you better pluck it off and go to heaven with one eye. Get me right. If it is any part of your body which would make you go to heaven, you'd better pluck it out and go to heaven without that part. Because in heaven, you don't need this physical body. But many times, we are looking for people who have no hands, so that they may have hands, and after receiving the hands, they get even to stealing where they are not stealing. And I'm saying this, our time is coming, and it is now, when the proper miracle will be. If you are here and you are a sinner and you have been stealing, I pray for God of heaven, before you come, these hearts of these people which have been troubling them in stealing, pluck them off. Uone mkutano watu wametoka bila mikono. That is a true miracle. That is a miracle of going to heaven. That's the miracle of righteousness. Lakini sio miracle ya kuweka mikono mtu aende akaibe. Pana ni miracle ya kuenda mbinguni. Kama unaweza kusema upate mikono, so that upate kumtumikia Bwana, let it be so. And God bless you. Lakini kwa sasa wale ambao tumewaona, ni wakusema miracle itendeke, ili wapatewe, waletewe pesa. Iyo nimekata katika jina la Yesu. Sio miracle ya kulipa. Usiripe kwa ene work that the Lord does on your on your ministry. So what I'm saying here is that in these last days, mutawaona na tumewaona, and I'm telling you, you who is listening to me this time, utapata kuokolewa. The Bible continues to say that. 24. For there shall arise false Christ and false prophets, and shall so great signs and wonders, in so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. Kwa hivyo nataka nikuambie, miujiza, si ati kuhaimanishi mtu ameokoka, amejazwa na roho sana. Hebu soma hapo, Matthew 24:24, and that is where we are now. That is where people are running. Nilisikia, ukiwaona hapo akinongozana, nilisikia, kuna mtu aliniombea, kuna mtu aliniombea. But I am telling you, si Biblia inauliza, kizima kimoja, kinaweza kutoka maji machungu, na kitoke maji, tamu aji. Why am I asking this? Because when you get into those false prophets, they don't care about your salvation. They don't care about your soul. They don't care about your future with God, your eternity. They are asking you about what you have, money, and then you receive a miracle. They don't care whether you are saved or not. And that is why I'm asking, and I'm saying, that light and darkness cannot move together. So, if the one who is in front of you, and you very much know that he is not even saved, na wewe uko saved hapa unapanga laini na unataka tukuingia kuhudumiwa. Can't you ask yourself kama uko na akili timamu, huyu mtu namjua, na tukienda pale hata aulizwa akoke, anaambiwa uko na shida, ila uko na shida kwa mkono wako wa kulia kwa nyumba, ako chini ya miguu kwenu shambani, huyo mtu unatakana ujue he is among us, the Matthew 24:24 prophets. This one I'm saying without any contradiction, because that is what the Bible says. I continue to tell you that we who are saved, the Bible tells us it would not be possible for them to deceive us. Oh, the last part of 24. It says, and shall so they shall so great signs and wonders in so much that if it were possible, that is the key word, if it were possible, but it is not going to be possible in Jesus' name, they say they shall deceive the very elect. Behold, I have told you before. Thank God, I have told you before. Signs and wonders should not direct and should not gauge your salvation. Your salvation should be gauged by what you are doing towards getting the kingdom, people to the kingdom of God. May God bless you. May God bless us all as we continue in this teaching of the end time, and we shall continue next time. Let us meet at this place, this hour. May God bless you. May God bless us all. Thank you.